Most fans have completely forgotten about LEGO Mindstorms. In fact, about 80% of LEGO enthusiasts think it has been discontinued. Believe it or not, you can actually buy LEGO Mindstorms right now on shop.lego.com for the same price of 350 bucks. This is insane, especially with its outdated technology and an embarrassingly low piece count. Because many Technic fans and serious LEGO engineers use Mindstorms to this day, we must ask ourselves the question, where does LEGO Mindstorms stand in 2019? Mindstorms is now nearly 6 years old, and this is terrible. It's like LEGO forgot it exists or just completely neglects its fan base. First of all, let's talk about the EV3 brick itself. It has an ARM9 CPU running Linux. This processor is incredibly slow, which can be seen when the EV3 brick powers up. It actually takes longer to turn on the brick than my work computer. That is ridiculous, especially considering that its predecessor only took about 3 seconds tops to power on. Moreover, in an age where we have smartphones with color LCD displays sold only for 50 bucks, it boggles my mind that this display only uses basic black-only pixels, not even monochrome, just black. Of course, this is done in order to keep the price low. However, I do have a potential solution. I am proposing a smartphone holder with the same overall size and shape as the current bricks to accommodate the existing Mindstorms models, but there will be a lightning to the EV3 motors and sensors converter. Using this method, I'm suggesting we can completely eliminate the cost of an EV3 brick and we can add more Technic pieces. Moreover, because this can be an iPhone, the new system will have an incredibly sharp OLED screen with an A12 Bionic processor. This would be truly revolutionary and it would completely eliminate any other competition such as Vex Robotics. Now let's talk about the sensors. I believe that all of these sensors are fine except for the NXT sound sensor. All it detects is the volume and whether or not the sound is actually present, meaning it can't actually differentiate between different words. All smartphones have some sort of digital assistant like Google Assistant, Bixby, Siri, and many more. Using Siri, for example, the robot can understand anything you say, and maybe you can even have a full-on conversation. That is why I believe using a smartphone would be leaps and bounds ahead of using something like an EV3 or an NXT brick. I also want to briefly discuss where LEGO is heading with its robotics department. In 2017, LEGO launched something called BOOST, which is actually inferior to LEGO Mindstorms. I get it, it's meant for younger kids. However, this is the latest robotics kit LEGO has made. You can't actually navigate within the Move Hub, and it only has 2 ports as opposed to the EV3, which has 8 ports. Moreover, the software is terrible. You can't actually name any of your programs, and it gives you silly names like Unicorn, Ava, Lance, or Macy. I don't know about you, but I like to name all of my programs on my own. That way, I have a much easier time managing all of them. Also, when you're building something using the instructions, like Verney, you get a terrible programming experience. You get these weird blocks which already have many pre-written commands in them. So your kid may be like, "Dad, I programmed my own robot!" When in reality, all he really did was take a set of pre-written commands and hit run. No programming at all. This was never the case with NXT, which had guided programming. It basically showed you what commands to write and it explained what each block does. I used NXT when I was 7 and I understood everything clearly and well. I even made the switch to NXC, and as you probably guessed, you can't program with NXC on Boost. But Boost does have one positive. You can actually integrate it with many LEGO sets like the roller coaster or the Ninjago Dragon. New Boost compatible sets are coming out all the time. This is your Brink Sales here, and I'll see you in the next one.